It does require a lot of training, and it does take a lot of patience to check some of the components.
Welcome to our CrowdStrike safety series. Today at the factory, we're going to look into NDT, non-destructive testing. This is where we ensure the reliability of our components using various methods to seek any early signs of wear and detect any imperfections that may have occurred during manufacture. Let's get into it. Camilla, there are thousands of metallic components on our F1 car. How do we test them before they go racing for the first time, but also between races when the car gets serviced?
So we've got a couple methods that we use in our factory. First one of all is eddy current inspection. So this little probe contains very tiny coil that produces magnetic field. So once you attach the probe to the part, it induces eddy currents into the part. And the job of this set is to track the changes in the magnetic field. So this is the actual part. And then we're hitting an indication. There's a little crack there. We can easily see a change in the signal. That's how we record our flaws. And then the next step will be just mark up the area and send it to design for approval.
Now, of course, not all of the components on the car are metallic. The vast majority of the car is made from carbon fibre, and for that, I understand we use ultrasound.
Yes, so this set is an ultrasonic testing set. This set also contains a probe, but it's a probe that contains piezoelectric crystal that inside. It increases, expands and shrinks, creating high frequency ultrasound waves. So there's a disturbance between the back wall of the part, so something's in there. So we can easily check whether the set is working correctly by finding the flaws.
Okay, so it seems like quite a labor-intensive process. Is there a way we can automate this process, or can we do numerous components at one time?
We've got other methods in NDT. One of them is called DPA, which is dye penetrant inspection. Numerous components can be put into the fluorescent liquid. They sit there for a certain amount of time to make sure all the fluorescents are getting into the indications. Then we would wash off the excess, dry the part, and then put it into a special dust cabinet that contains the developer that helps out to draw the flaws. And then we would inspect it under the UV light. So we'll easily see if there's a crack because it would be illuminating.
So CrowdStrike knows that any small inclusion can have catastrophic consequences, and the same is true for us. So how do we combat that?
We're getting part service or news. We scan 100% of a part, and then whenever we find anything, we mark up, put a depth on it, put a size on it, and then we send it via design office to make a decision on it.
Okay, so it's maybe a continual process, that kind of design and feedback loop. Skilled technicians in NDT must have a huge amount of patience and eye for detail.
It does require a lot of training, and it does take a lot of patience to check some of the components.
And I think it just goes to show it's one of those departments that a lot of people might not be aware of, but it's absolutely crucial to the safety of everyone involved in the sport.